testing of your faith is perseverance. I chose this verse because this verse becomes a right hand. There's an active trial that God does and wants you to consider your joy. Because when your faith is tested, you become stronger, and good always comes out of it. When I am faced with a trial, I go back to this verse and remind me to think of the positives of my faith is being tested. God will use the trial to ask me in my life that is good. John 3:16 helps us have one faith, because all faith is leaving, and the verse gives us a promise, and all God's promises are the promises that we can stand on. And if you have faith, you are a Christian. John 3:16 is also a verse I can look back on as a promise. I've always had faith in my life, even when I was very young. Everyone around me had faith, so I was just a follower and I just believed. Growing up, I went to church with my family all the time, and I thought it would be just crazy thing when I got older. As I got a little older, I started to question it because I was curious, and I realized all the people that were following me and all the people that had real life experiences with God. So I continued to believe this had never hurt me before. Then I started Sunday school and heard all the fun stories that I wanted to believe more, but I still haven't gotten to the point where it would be effective. I never had any big problems with college when I was younger. It would just be when I got a bad rating on my degree or got in trouble at school. Be nothing too serious. I always heard of people having bad things happen to them. I would feel sympathy for them, but nothing. I never thought anything bad could ever happen. When I started middle school, I was bullied in sports, just like everybody else. And I thought I would always have them. I've heard people having injuries or other things that would make them give up their sport. Again, I felt bad, but I never thought it would happen to me. My eighth grade year, I tore my ACL in my knee playing football in our first game. At first, it was a little hard because I never missed a game or practice due to an injury, so it was different for sure. Before my injury, I thought about what it would be like to miss an entire year of sports at the time. At the time, I thought it would kill me, and there was no way I could handle it. So when I heard the news, I was devastated. As it went on, I got more and more frustrated. I had a surgery planned, and I was really nervous, so I really prayed for the first time. God started giving me that I'm good from the injury, and my surgery went well. Then I also gave God thanks for the first time. After that, I was blessed with strength to work hard and try to return. All was going along to the spring of that year, my brother had passed. Before that, I also imagined what it would be like to lose a family member. I didn't think that I'd be able to handle that either, so I was in denial. When I was younger, all of us siblings were really close, and we did a lot of things together. So I was close to my brother, Mike. And as I got older, I was kind of drifting away from him. We played video games together, but he was gone most of the time, so we weren't as close. As I remember watching his football games every Friday night. I just remember watching his football games every Friday night. But I still miss him every day. After that, I started to feel angry with God and started asking why not. Why not anybody else? Why me? Why not anybody else? So I took a break from him and tried to figure things out on my own. That made things way more stressful. And I asked God to forgive me and come back to my life, and he did. That's when I first heard the phrase, let go and let God. So I did, and he figured things out for me in his plan. I wanted to work hard and come back and play for Mike that season. I started the season the next fall, and things were going well. I made the varsity team, and I felt a part of things against my friends. So a couple games in, I got hurt again. The next day, when my heart was broken, finding the results on the MRI, that I would have to sit out for another year of sports. That moment, I was sure I didn't know what to do, what I was going to do. I was lost and I didn't think I was wrong. I stopped trying in school, and it was the hardest month of my life. Then I decided to let go and let God in. And I found myself in the God who was my life. At that point, I stopped feeling sorry for myself and I decided to work hard and get sports under the shot. That summer, I was facing big decisions that stressed me out, and I let go and let God and he led me places. That summer, I went on two amazing trips that brought me closer to Christ than I ever thought I would ever be. It got me to close one of the best weeks of my life. I actually listened to the lyrics and realized a strong word. I also gained I still face daily trials. This is the best my life has ever been. God took away some things, but he replaced them with the best of all, by giving me the opportunity to draw near to him and draw near to me. James 4. The book of James relates to my life a lot. Coincidence of study on the tour. I was also given a Christian officer, so my role now I have to lead people and serve Paul. Romans 1:16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel for it is. Youth gathering was also amazing. I got the opportunity to worship with 30,000 other teens in one place. And I really got to see the city of Detroit and all the examples and how there are people who want to change and really see in person. Even after all the people say about the city, they keep a positive attitude and people out there are still trying to make a change. Thanking us for helping out as well. We helped clean up the alleys, and every time somebody walked by, they were grateful for what we were doing. It was hot and long, but I felt like we did a good thing afterwards. I hope God has not finished with it yet, and I can't wait to see what more joys he brings to bless my life. I pray that out of his glorious riches, he makes strength in you and power of the Holy Spirit.
Worship shouldn't just be 1 hour every Sunday, and on this trip we worship every day. amazing to see all the people that were there to help that town, and knowing that they were all there for God was also amazing. That last night on the trip, we had a foot washing service. My mom washed my feet. While she was washing my feet, I felt the love all around me, and I got this feeling inside of me that is very hard to explain. I felt God's presence in that one tiny room. It was an amazing trip, and I can't wait until the next one. My 9th grade year was full of many ups and downs. My brother getting hurt, me getting hurt, my brother getting sick. I'm a person who worries and stresses about a lot about family, friends, school, music, and sports. Most things I stress and worry about are probably things other people don't worry about. Sometimes I question myself, and that makes me question God. But I know that if I put all my trust in Him, it doesn't matter what I'm doing, because He's always going to be there for me, even if it doesn't seem like it. He's there. He is there. He'll never leave my side. I felt like God was testing me that last year, and in fact, I didn't like it very much. I was frustrated with Him and with myself. That year, I joined Agapes. Going to Agapes every week really helped me get back to talking to God about everything that goes on in my life and having Him be more present in my life. This past summer, I went on two amazing trips. The first was Agapes tour, and it was my first tour of many Agapes tours. I really didn't know what to expect going on tour, so I just kept an open mind. It didn't matter to me where we were going, because it's not about the destination, it's about growing closer to people and God. That week I grew closer to many others, who I now call great friends, and most importantly, I grew closer to God. I made great memories on the tour, and I will never forget them. I realized that no matter what I do, God is always going to be there for me. He has a plan, a great plan for me, and I need to put all my trust in Him and believe that everything is going to be okay. The last trip I went on this past summer was the National Youth Gathering in Detroit. I had mixed emotions going on this trip because I had no idea what to expect like I do with the Gabi tour. That week we had many great speakers come talk to us, and we helped the people of Detroit by just having a service day. I have this stuff line that I got in Detroit. The line is wearing a shirt, and it says, God's work, our hands. On that service day, that is exactly what we did. That week, I learned that many of us have great lives compared to others, and I should be very grateful for what I have. Detroit is a beautiful and amazing city, and lots of people misinterpret the city. It's rising back up with the help of God and many others. No matter where I go or what I end up doing in life, I will always be looking up to God to help and guide me. Through ups and downs, He's always going to be there for me. I will put all my trust in Him and let go and let Him take care of things. And I'm spread His love to others. 1 Corinthians 13:13 says, and now these three things remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. I love God, and that will never stop. My faith will always be growing, and I'm excited to see how much it will grow and what God has in store.
My name is Buster Gruel, and I'd like to share my reported faith statement with you all. Who is Jesus Christ? Jesus is the Spirit who watches over me in my darkest times. He guides me through the hard times and helps me find my place in this world created by God, Jesus' Father. Jesus helps me make decisions and plan out my faith in life, like who I should spend the rest of my life with, when I'm ready to start to raise a family of my own. Jesus is there for me every day of every month. Jesus has also sacrificed more than anyone could offer, His own life on the cross. That is why He is a God to me as well. This is why I chose my confirmation verse to be John 4:9. God's love is revealed among us in this way. God sent His only Son into this world so that we might live through Him. What is the truth to me? I feel the truth is a place where we can all be ourselves. It is a safe haven for your prayers to be heard by God. They cared for him, and in return he granted him miracles.
mistakes, I believe that Jesus, who is perfect and pure, died for our sins, and so that we can be forgiven and saved from judgment. We often sin with good intent and for the greater good of our family, but too easily forget the greater good of all. We are all children of the Lord, and there is no place for selfishness in God's family. Paul writes in 2 Corinthians 7:10-11, godly sorrow brings repentance that leads to salvation and leaves no regret, but worldly sorrow brings death. Once we recognize and accept ourselves as sinners, we can ask for forgiveness and spend eternity with God in heaven. My faith is found throughout my life when God has helped me when times are bad.
They taught me to say prayers every morning and every night, and sing praises in church on a Sunday morning. They read me my first Bible story and taught me that Jesus is God's Son. As a godmother, it was then my own responsibility to keep learning and growing in my faith. I still remember to pray to Him every morning and every night, but as years went by, my words became more serious and my heart began to know more. Still being so young, there was so much more stuff to wonder about my faith than the world around me, and there still is. Describing your faith to someone is a hard thing to do. We all share the same faith and say the same prayers. We all think about it differently and react to situations different than a friend would. What one sermon might mean to me could mean something totally different to another. So how does one go on about describing your faith? You start by looking back at your life and thinking about certain decisions you've made and why you made those decisions. You know God was in your head and heart at those times to help you through those tough choices. To me, being a Lutheran and a Christian isn't just about going to church on Sundays. It is about all the things you do between those Sundays that matter to Him. You take what you've learned at the start of the week and carry it till the end. He wants us to be genuine, kind, caring, and helpful beings. He doesn't want us to leave any one of His children behind. Being a Christian in this day and age is important to remember that not everyone is a Christian. Even though you want so badly to get through to someone and help them out, their hearts just aren't open to the possibility of believing it. He still would not want us to give up on those people. Take the time and spread His word as often as you can and as many places as you can, because that can make a difference in someone's life. Finding a Bible verse was very difficult for me. I wanted it to be something that I would always remember and something that could comfort me. I chose Isaiah 46:4. Even to your old age and gray hairs, I am He. I am He who will sustain you. I have made you and I will carry you. I will sustain you and I will rescue you. This verse speaks to me in so many aspects of my life. My darkest times when I think I am all alone, He always rescues me and carries me to the better days. He is the reason I can get through those days and wake up the next one with a lighter and more hopeful heart. I know that no matter what stage of my life I'm in, and no matter what troubles I'm facing, I now realize that He will rescue me. Even when I'm in despair and can't see the light of day, God is when He opens the window and lets the light shine in. Sometimes I can feel His presence in my life, telling me to keep going because happier times are ahead. I feel grateful and blessed to know this now. At times when my faith is tested, I just want to fall into the conformity of what is already accepted by others. Sometimes doing good is hard. It should be the other way around. God tests us by putting us into those situations so that when the next problem arises, I know to do what He would want me to do. Our faith is tested every day that we live, every place that we go, and every conversation that we have. When I find myself in a situation like that, I remember to say a prayer and ask Him to give me strength and courage to make it another day. Being a member of a Christian church, I look up at my eyes and how lucky I am to be a part of something bigger than myself. In my church, I'm able to travel to places near and far to help spread His word, like going to Detroit to the youth gathering, Agape Tour, and mission trips. I'm able to join a group like the Agapes and worship Him with kids my age. I'm even able to help out around my own community by showing others His love. A couple of summers ago, I was blessed enough to be able to go on a mission trip, where I met amazing people who taught me so many things. Even though they had little on earth, their faith was not so much of them. That experience humbled me and let me start to think about life in a new light. It also made me question lots of things about my faith, such as why I was born into a Christian family who loved, cared, and provided for me, but another child wasn't granted the same. This will forever baffle me, and I know that because at a good start, I must use my faith to have a greater outcome and help someone in need. Something I feel strongly about is that everyone should have an equal chance to make it in this world, and God is the way that that will be able to happen. Maybe one day God will use me to help someone who needs Him in their life. I don't know what road He is bringing me down just yet, but I do know that He has never has or ever will leave my side during my journey. Because He has made me and He will always rescue me, I will never forget this.
My name is Melissa Stolten. My face is in my mind. Because I don't like a lot of things. I don't like going to church because I have trouble paying attention when people talk. makes me feel better about everything. Just how their eyes light up because they meet new people and they see how people will help them. I was always afraid to do things like this because I thought people would judge me. I realized that it was only fear though, because once people say that fear is good, but fear is also an illusion that God put in our minds to help us overcome things. I don't really know what happened, so I haven't had a favorite verse at all. But I was on an app and I found a picture of a verse and I really liked it. The verse is 1 Peter 3:3-4. Do not adorn yourselves outwardly by braiding your hair or by wearing gold ornaments or fine clothing. Rather, let your adornment be the inner self with the last of beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is very precious in God's sight. This verse just tells me that I shouldn't wear fancy clothes or jewelry. People should accept me for what I wear and do. And that is the most important thing to God in life. I like to think that He didn't make us all the same for a reason. We are meant to be special for someone and to help others be themselves. If God wanted us all to be the same, then He would have made us all the same. A person's soul is like no one else's. No one else can have a soul like yours, and you have to show people that you are not like anyone else. This is why it is my favorite verse. I haven't had an incident in my life that I remember to tell you how I came close to God, but I guess that's good in a way, because it means I haven't lost anyone that I love, and I haven't gotten any bad news. For those who have lost anyone and had bad news recently, I want you to know that God is there, and He is listening to everything you say. He knows you are angry because this happened to you, and He knows you don't understand why, but just know sometimes life isn't fair, but it will get better. I am very happy to be part of this class. They have helped me understand God in different ways, and they help me understand that everyone has a different way of telling what God is like. That's what I find most fun to learn about. All religions have their own way of telling you what God or what Jesus is like, but everyone believes that He's watching over all of us. I believe God is a man who has died for us because He believes in people. I believe He is a man who listens to someone when they need it. I believe God shows Himself to people the way we want to see Him as a best friend, family member, someone we love, or someone special to you. That is my version of God. Thank you to everyone who has helped me know God is out there and He will continue to matter. Not long after that, I lost my broken leg. I didn't know what to think or do. They say there are five stages to grief. First comes denial, then anger, then mourning, depression, and then acceptance. The denial seemed to last a long time. Things could have taken a while in some days, but now it's still hard for me to understand. Within 1 month, I lost everything. I lost my mom, my sister, my dad, my brother, and myself. I became really good at walking out of like oceans, building homes so high that no one ever had a chance to help them. Every single night, I would lay on my grandma's couch and cry so hard and look at God, asking why he'd do this to me. And all of a sudden, a little girl sat in the front pew, a little off to the left, messy hair and clothes under my hatch. I became a teenager, laying in bed, curled up in a ball, a little off to the left, and messy eyes as hell that never lasted. I learned to look at the world with shaded eyes, accepting the fact that everyone needs that's all there is to it. But even though through all this, I managed to put on a happy face each morning because I knew that I had reached out to my sister. I made the world believe that I was okay. I started going to confirmation and Grace lived there because I wanted so desperately to be able to understand why God would take me away. I wish I could see that I had faith through all my troubles, but I didn't. I think that is the hardest thing for a person to admit, that they weren't always strong when they were not to me. I let go of myself, and with that, with my faith, and that is honestly the biggest regret I have in my life. But one day, on a chilly winter afternoon, things got bad again. My sister and I had to go live with these doctors. Let me tell you, it was really weird at first, but living with your best friend is not always easy. But we soon became accustomed to our new lifestyle and started going to church each and every Sunday. I started to fall back into my faith, and I can tell you the exact moment I completely, totally, and utterly let myself go to God and caught a grasp of who I used to be. It was the summer of 2014 on the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation. After a long week of helping people in need, we were doing a foot wash, and where our group leaders came and washed our feet.